What is going on, Governors? Chisgule here, and today we are going to help you prepare for the first ever annual Rise of Kingdoms Festival. If you like Rise of Kingdoms videos where we prepare for events, then you should like and subscribe because we give you the inside tips on how you can prepare and win. My friends, there is a lot to prepare for, but good news, some of what is coming has just arrived. The new legendary commander that you get just for logging in is already here. That's right, they've arrived. Log in over the course of the next 8 days. You'll pick up a cool 80 sculptures. We're going to talk about what you should do with this commander. P.S. We're also going to make some gear in this video. I'm so obsessed with gear. Let's get a quick look at Sundiak. I'm not going to go over all of their skills. I'm just going to point out that the skill that really matters on a commander like this is the second skill. The second skill is related to gathering speed. This is a gathering commander. You should use them for that. I don't know. You really, like, do not use this commander for battling. They're a gatherer, so since they're a gatherer, what I would recommend is that after you unlock them, take them immediately to 2 stars to unlock the second skill. Try to max that second skill, because really, you shouldn't fight with this commander, you just gather with them, and that's great. With the 80 sculptures that you have, you'll have enough to, I believe, max 1 skill, and then put points into another one. So in your perfect world, you'd end up with a 2-5 Sundiak. I think that's right off the top of my head, but it's close enough. The point is, unlock the second skill, start putting skill points in, hope you max this thing out, and then wait until you've maxed the first skill before you proceed starring up this commander. There's really not a lot of reason to star them up. You can use them as a secondary commander to your other gathering commanders. Card up in the top if you want a full guide on gathering. That's not why you're here. You're here because there is crucial preparations that you can start to make for the crazy events that are coming. Oh my gosh, we got to talk about league bets too. We'll get to it. The first anniversary festival is coming, and there's going to be a bunch of stuff you're used to, events over the course of a bunch of days. There's going to be stuff you're used to, probably where you run around, kill barbarians, and all that kind of stuff to get goodies that you trade in toward an alliance event. We're used to that. You'll get some goodies. They're not going to be out of this world, but they're basically going to be free for doing stuff you would have done anyways, and that's cool. The thing that you might consider preparing for, is the event that is probably going to be Cross Kingdom for this crazy Age of Devotion skin. Now, most of us are not going to get the skin. The thing you're ultimately working toward is the stuff that's along the way. Assuredly, there's going to be some legendary commander sculptures if you train a bunch of troops. That's usually how it goes. In a perfect world, this might actually 100% align with your Mighty Governor cycle. That would be amazing. In other ways, it's actually kind of not amazing, because that means the same people who are going to win Mighty Governor are also going to win this fancy skin. We'll talk about the skin in just a second, whether or not you should even be going for it. But what I want to call out here is that I might actually not participate in the event for this skin, depending on how many kingdoms are involved, because I would rather wait until everybody goes completely ham trying to win this event that they probably aren't going to win anyways to then spend in the next Mighty Governor cycle. Probably shouldn't have mentioned that because now other people are going to copy the strategy, but whatever. We bring you the truth of what we're thinking about doing here. We'll see. It's going to be a game time decision. This comes in less than 22 hours, and our Mighty Governor training day is a day and 22 hours away, so we'll see. We definitely want to unlock this commander in the very least. So with all of that said, is this skin particularly worth it? Well, maybe. Maybe it is. Here is what you can get for, I believe, the top 10 or so placements, probably across a bunch of kingdoms, but I don't know for sure. That's how the last one was. It's called the Age of Devotion, giving 10% infantry health. You lose 5% cavalry attack, and you lose 5% archer defense. Look, if you're the rally leader and you're leading with all infantry, this skin is good. If you're leading rallies with mixed armies or you're not a rally leader, like, there's nothing very critical about all of this infantry boost unless you're like a gun-ho infantry commander, but I don't know if that really makes sense for folks to specialize in commanders in that way. You kind of want to have a balanced portfolio of commanders anyways for when things go into favor and out of favor, also known as the meta. So the other thing I'm going to call attention to is that this skin that offers 10% of infantry health looks a lot like these Babylonian gardens, except the Babylonian Gardens gives 10% infantry attack. Now, I'd kind of rather have the attack rather than the health. There's perhaps an argument to be made that health is better than attack. But if you've already got the Babylonian Guardians, I mean, do you really need the other skin too? Like, it's basically the same thing. So, I don't know. Hopefully this gives more people an opportunity to get a skin that's basically the same thing. And the same people hopefully don't go for it. But kind of people that win this kind of skin, usually, they just go for everything. So, is there other preparation you can do? Make sure you've got some action points saved up. That seems pretty important. You're going to need those for an event where you run around and kill a bunch of barbarians, as many as possible in a short window of time. That's going to be a weird event to do. In part because everybody else in the kingdom's going to be doing it at the same time. We'll see how the details of that work out. A few other things to be thinking about is that there is almost always a bundle that shows up. Almost always a bundle that shows up when there's one of these events that comes around. I would be shocked if that was not the case here. You can probably plan to spend $385 if that's a thing you plan to do, maxing out chests. Just guessing that might be a thing. We'll see. We'll see, and when that happens, if it happens, we'll evaluate it in the channel. We're actually going to, today, go in and max purchase the Call of the Ancients. After we've done that, we're going to go and we're going to craft a new weapon. And we are so pumped about this weapon, by the way. We are so, so pumped about the Staff of the Lost, baby. Oh yeah, a lot to talk about here. First things first, let's go buy some bundles. We need some gems. We've upped our spend in the game recently, so let's go and purchase Call of the Ancients. Now, we'll show on the screen what's in each of these tiers. You've seen me buy this bundle. We've bought this bundle in a bunch of videos. A whole bunch of videos, because we think it's really, really good. You saw in my KVK coverage, I'll put a card or two up in the top, that we used a lot of healing speed-ups really quickly. The healing speed-ups are great, the training speed-ups are great, the generic speed-ups we'll use for training troops, and the army expansions, premium, also the reserves we're going to use for training troops and resources are good too. So let's buy this $20 tier. Okay. Now we go in and spend $50, more speed ups. We get an attack buff, but like, whatever, it's not a big deal. Let's buy it. All right. Now we go in and buy the $100 bundle for as many times as the hell let us do it. Whew, that's $100. P.S., here's what's contained within that. The 4-hour army expansion is crucial, 50% mark. For that army expansion, 50% more troops, really big deal. And the reserves are exceptional. We use these for rapidly training troops during Mighty Governor with the general, because they don't just let you sit there for like an hour, which is what it takes to go through, I don't know, the 60,000 plus points we'll score during Mighty Governor. If you don't have these reserves, you can't train the troops fast enough with the general buff, which, like, you definitely want that extra 10%. P.S., it's not general anymore, it's Duke. And that is something I'm really happy about. Let's stop talking and buy this $100 bundle. Now, you may be wondering, like, Chisgule, you're maybe spending more in the game than you usually do. I try to put most of my spending onto the channel. We were doing actually a bunch of spending on Hammer and Anvil just like leading up to KVK because I thought we'd be able to get a Staff of the Lost. I thought it would matter for the rallies. And then they put a weapon kind of, well, it's not kind of better, it's just better than the Staff of the Lost, into the VIP 16 chest. So, like, it ended up not being as urgent, but that's fine. We've upped our spend. We're max spinning wheels now. I regret not doing that for other commanders, so I'm not going to commit that mistake again. And we also are buying freaking VIP sculptures, legendary commander sculptures from that VIP shop, which is, I mean, you know, it's like 20 sculpts for 40k gems every week. That's going to add up. So let's spend another 100 bucks here. There we go. The third $100 purchase of Call of the Ancients. Max purchased, sold out indeed. Taking a step back and looking what we need to go and do here. We're deficient on a couple really crucial buffs here. Holy cheese. How is it that we don't have gathering speed going? Oh my gosh. And we're missing food boost? Give me a break. Give me a freaking break. There we go. Let's get that taken care of. Now, we need to go craft this bad boy over here. The Staff of the Lost. Now, we put a lot of thought into the Staff of the Lost. What kind of commander does this belong on? If we get the special talent. If we get the special talent on the Staff of the Lost, what should we pick? Should it be infantry? Should it be archers? Don't put this on cavalry. This is not a cavalry weapon. Cavalry have plenty of weapons that they can go on and use, right? The other thing we can consider is, should it be on a leadership commander? Is there a leadership commander? Because then you actually potentially get the benefit of all those troop types. Conceivable that if you were to get the special talent, it should be a leadership commander. Here's what we think based on the availability of these weapons. If you have access to Trial of the Lost Kingdom, this makes it so that, I mean, like, look, you're going to put this on your garrison commander. You're going to put this potentially on a commander you're using to rally stuff if you're using a mixed army, although you probably won't be. This weapon offers a lot of flexibility. It covers archers, covers infantry. You wouldn't probably use it on cavalry, interestingly, because you've already got like 10% of stats over here, basically. Right, you've got 9% plus the 2% set bonus. So you don't need to put this on a cavalry commander, although you could if you haven't crafted this guy over here. I don't know why you wouldn't have crafted this. So what that means to me is we should go and look at what other weapons are available. We know this is a cavalry weapon, so cavalry's already kind of really covered. This weapon here is also a cavalry weapon. Heart of the Saint. It's pretty good for archers too, however, but it's only available from Ancient Ruins and the Altar of Darkness. We found it to be pretty rare. It's unlikely you're getting this. The other weapon you are very likely to be able to eventually craft is the Golden Age. The Golden Age is available to you from Sunset Canyon. We've only got 3 blueprints, so this is going to take a while, but eventually we'll have enough, and we'll actually probably get the blueprints before we even have the materials to go and craft it. But eventually, you would want this weapon, most likely, for an archer commander. You'd want to use the special talent for archers if you happen to win the lottery on that one. So what that says to me is that eventually I'll do archers on this weapon over here. So with the Staff of the Lost, I think I can go with infantry. I think I can go with infantry and feel pretty good about boosting the effectiveness of my infantry commanders, right? And if we just get one last look at, okay, what other commanders should we be considering? P.S. We should summon this commander, right? Bada boom. She is summoned, naturally. Naturally. And by the way, when you summon a new legendary commander, you get this sweet bundle that pops up. And this is really good value. I have to disclose I'm a sponsored creator, but this is, wait, no, point over here. This is really good value if you're spending money in Rise of Kingdoms. Really, you get a lot of legendary commander sculptures for the $5 you spend, right? Like, here you're spending $5 and getting 10. If I'm going into the VIP shop, I'm going to be spending 20,000 gems. And you saw how much money it takes, you know, to get 25,000 gems. It's $100. So, yeah, it's pretty good way of acquiring those. Let's just pick this darn thing up now. Okay. we have acquired the Writer of History bundle, more Legendary Commander sculptures, making it rain, and we're going to keep good on our word here, and we're going to level up this commander to level 10, because we said that's what you should do, so we're going to go and do that. Bada boom. They're now level 10. We're going to star them up once to make sure that we get that gold gathering speed bonus and the bonus for other resources. Here we go. We'll do this. Yeah, sure. This is fine. Eventually, we'll star them up more. Bada boom. Second skill is unlocked, which is excellent. So we can actually start to use this commander for gathering gold as a secondary. Not so bad. They can gather other stuff too, and they're pretty good for that. The thing I wanted to show you is just getting a look at the commanders, right? So Yi Song Ye, we already have the staff of, or the Trial of the Lost Kingdom equipped to them. Richard I is where we're going to put the Staff of the Lost when we get it, and we'll give it the infantry special talent if we can. Another commander we could consider is Charles Martel in the garrison. When we use him as a garrison commander, though, we're just going to drop this over here, which actually ends up being probably still more total stats than Staff of the Lost if you have the infantry talents. Anyways, we're not really using Barca to rally stuff these days, so Barca is not where that would go. We could put it onto Khan, except this combination, as I was describing earlier, is the way better combination. We don't use Freddy as a primary. We're using Sun Tzu as a primary to support Alexander the Great. We may star up Alexander the Great because he's just a beast, which means, once again, picking infantry would be a pretty solid choice. I'm feeling like infantry is the special talent choice to pick with that weapon. So let's go. Let's craft it, and hopefully we get the special talent. If not, all this extra thinking was for nothing. But you want to do the extra thinking, because once you smash the forge button, there's no going back. By the way, this pattern is obtainable from Sunset Canyon, and the way that we get lots of easy Sunset Canyon wins is to basically drop our defense entirely, let our rating drop a bunch, and then get 7 fast, easy wins. So here we go. We're going to smash the button to forge Staff of the Lost. Okay. No special talent. All that extra thinking was completely not needed. But the good news is we've got this sweet new weapon. We're going to put it onto Richard I. Bada boom. 5% infantry defense is a really solid boost. And because it doesn't have the special talent, of course, it really doesn't matter what kind of commander you move it around to. It's a pretty freaking sweet weapon. It is a sweet weapon. Now, the other thing we can start to do now that we've got this like major craft out of the way, we're probably thinking about crafting some other really cool stuff. I would like to go and ultimately get another set of infantry gear, right? Like, this Sun Tzu, he needs some stuff. He really needs some stuff. Am I missing a helmet? I could take this off my garrison. Yeah, we don't need garrison gear anymore. We need a chest piece. We need some pants for this commander. Maybe we gotta get some stuff here. So probably our next craft will be probably either the infantry breastplate, or since we already kind of have one of those and we have none of these boots over here, I'm actually inclined to lean in the direction of making the edged boots. And much to my surprise, I think I have the materials for this. I think we could kind of do this like now. I think we do it. I think we make the edged boots too. And this is a cavalry gear piece. The reason I say that is that you could just use sturdy boots on archers. So that goes on archers. This goes on your cavalry. And it's such a small amount of stats. Like, you don't need to pick leadership if you were going with leadership commanders for some reason. So let's go in. Gosh darn it. Let's go in and let's pick up the feathers we need. Let's pick up the feathers we need to craft this thing. if we head over to our forge and we go to the combination, you can see we've already like combined a lot of materials here. I'm instead going to head over to my material crates, and we need 18 feathers. So we'll go in, we'll go to 18. And the reason, by the way, I'm using the higher tier of material, not the lower tiers of material, is that you can always upgrade lower tiers of material, but you cannot downgrade material pieces. So you always want to use your higher tiers of material chests first, if you can. So we're going to pop this. We're going to select the feathers, hit confirm. There we go. Those are picked up. Now we can go in to boots, and we can craft the edged boots. Amazing. I love this progress we're making here. The windswept boots would be better, but those come from the Shadow Legion invasion. The cloud racers are really quite strong from Sunset Canyon. They're going to take a long time to get the pattern for, and quite frankly, the amount of materials for 2% of stat points is just staggering. These are really more gathering boots than anything else. Ugh, gross. So let's grab the etched boots to put 1% extra attack onto our main cavalry army. Here we go. We're going to smash the button for forge. Boom. Edged boots obtained. No special talent, but that's cool. We can roll with it. So we're going to go in to our con. We're going to drop those on. Bada boom. And we've now got more stats onto con. I'll take it, baby. I'll freaking take it. Now, if we go in here, have we completed a milestone for crafting? Almost, but not quite. Almost, but not quite. Saint's Song blueprints are on the way. The Commander's Heavy Armor blueprints are on the way. We'll have those very soon. I'm inclined to believe that one of the next things we'll go and craft, as I mentioned, is this infantry breastplate. That is likely to be an immediate craft. I'd like to do something like this Commander's Heavy Armor, but it's just going to take a while. Like, the blue materials take a really long time to do. I also, of course, am very interested in these Greaves of Exile. We have a lot of the patterns that we seem to get for this. We've got one full version of the pattern already, and we're like halfway to our next one, which is pretty nuts. I'm interested in crafting these. It's just that they take so many materials. It's going to be a week or two. It's going to be a week or two before that happens. Whew. So, my friends, hopefully you've enjoyed this video where we talk a little bit about preparation for the events in the next coming days. Gosh darn it, there's so much to talk about. One last thing that is really good is Arco Osiris League bets are coming. Here's how this works. When the playoffs begin, you can place bets every week from Monday to Saturday. You place bets on each battle, but you can only bet on one side of the battle. So you can't bet for like both sides. That's weird. You pick one side and that's the side you can bet on. You can raise your bet. You can't withdraw it once you've made your bet. And you earn, it says Oryx. Oryx are earned from the League Bets and Allure of Gold event. So there's going to be some event that comes around related to this that gives you some goodies you're going to trade in. And at the end of each battle, all your bets placed on the losing side are divided up among the governors who place bets on the winning side. You're literally taking the goodies from the people who bet on the loser, and the winnings are proportional to the amount that you bet. In addition, you get back all the money from your original placement if you were the winner. So if I bet, I don't know what we're betting actually, but like 100 gold, then I would get my 100 gold back plus a share of the pot. At the end of each battle, the losing governors are returned half of their original bet, which like, you should be betting. You should really be betting. Why is that? Why is it that Chisgule is encouraging you to bet? Because if you win, you get prizes and your money back. If you lose, you only lose half of what you bet. I guess we need to see like just how much the winnings end up being, but that seems likely to me to be a situation that you end up going positive on, especially if you just use power as a guideline for whether or not a side is going to win. Not that power is the sole determining factor. It's not. We've seen a few upsets in Arc of Osiris League, but not very many. So I would recommend you probably place some bets and, gosh darn it, have some fun doing it. All right, we're going to go for real. We got to verify our account before it gets held hostage. Hopefully you enjoyed this video where we spent $390, crafted some sweet, rare, and advanced gear, and until next time, you have fun smashing the kingdom. Come on. Verification, are you serious? Give me a break. We're trying to make a video. We're trying to make a video. Why are you still watching me verify? It's not that interesting, is it? All right. All right. Thanks again for watching. Like and subscribe.